So Still's disease is an autoinflammatory condition. It affects children and adults. In children, it's the terminology is SJIA, or systemic onset juvenile idiopathic arthritis. Whereas in adults, it's called adult onset Still's disease, but it's the same spectrum of disease. So Still's disease can present in a spectrum of symptoms, and that's what makes it hard sometimes to diagnose. But the usual triad of symptoms is fevers, rash, and joint pain. And again, the rash can be very different in different patients. The fevers can be very different in different patients. So that's why it's a difficult to diagnose disease. Still's is usually diagnosed after multiple other things are ruled out. Make sure there's no infection or malignancy or something else which can present like this. And also there's certain specific blood tests and an exam that most rheumatologists would do before diagnosing Still's disease. So Still's disease can be treated with many drugs now. Back in the day, there were not a lot of drugs. There was like probably one or two, like methotrexate. But now, with the onset of new biologics and FDA approval, there's much more medications that we can offer to Still's disease patients. I think it's important in Still's disease for early referral and early treatment of these patients, because there have been clinical studies showing that if these patients are treated early, they have much better long-term prognosis as compared to somebody who's treated late in the disease stage. So diagnosing it, recognizing it early, and starting treatment early is important.